welcome you into our house, and as we enter, create our sacred space, regardless of what the time of day is, let us come together, lift up our hearts, and let there be light. Help us to create our sanctuary. Sanctuary with the presence of hope. Sanctuary where there is unity amongst diversity. The diversity in your creation, which is far vast than the human imagination. Help us, Christ, to see your face amongst the incredible diversity that we see and do not see. Amen. Let us grow in faith from Arabian Nights. The set of stories which includes even Aladdin, the magic lamp. However, we're going to be quoting from Sinbad the Sailor. Fear only God, not human, nor beast, nor jinn, nor death. Fear only God, and you will be safe. One word, jinn. What is that? It's not human, spirit. Could be something scary, but we'll save that for another day. So, what's Sinbad telling us? To keep our focus on God. Amen.
Jesus walked in wisdom. Jesus grew in truth.
Calling me to come and walk with you. The Old Testament reading is Jonah 3, 1 to 5 and 10. The word of the Lord came to Jonah a second time, saying, "Get up and go to Nineveh, the great city, and proclaim it the message that I tell you." So Jonah set out and went to Nineveh, according to the word of the Lord. Now Nineveh was an exceeding large city, 3 days' walk across. Jonah began to go into the city, going a day's walk. Then he cried out, 40 days more, and Nineveh shall be overthrown." And the people of Nineveh believed God, and they proclaimed a fast. And everyone, great and small, put on sackcloth. When God saw what they did, how they turned from their evil ways, God changed his mind about the calamity that he had said he would bring upon them, and he did not do it. Now reading from the Qur'an scripture, the one who lines up, 37, 138 to 144, "And by night will ye not understand? And so also was Jonah among those sent by us. When he ran away, like a slave from captivity to a ship fully laden, he agreed to cast lots, and he was condemned. Then the big fish did swallow him, and he had done acts worthy of blame, had it not been that he repented and glorified Allah, he would certainly have remained inside the fish till the day of resurrection." Now the gospel reading is Mark 1, 14 to 20, the beginning of the Galilean ministry. Now after John was arrested, Jesus came to Galilee, proclaiming the good news of God and saying, "The time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news." Jesus calls his first disciples. As Jesus walked along the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and his brother Andrew casting a net into the sea, for they were fishermen. And Jesus said to them, "Follow me, and I will make you fishers of people." And immediately they left their nets and followed him. As he went a little further, he saw James, the son of Zebedee, and his brother John, who were in their boat mending the nets. Immediately he called them, and they left their father Zebedee in the boat with the hired men and followed him.
Fishing, folks, I have a whale tale to tell you, right from our gospel reading. Jesus is going to make them, the disciples, fishers of people. Well, human quality, be good, and it can lead people in difficult straits, sometimes large numbers of people, even a whole country, stubbornness, and you need a strong test of fishing line to reel them in. However, when we peer into the water, and what if there's something massive there? Ooh, big enough to swallow a human. This like you're looking on the screen right now. Jonah 3, 1 through 5, and chapter 10, right at the very beginning. Let's go look right there. Within the Hebrew, it's very interesting, God, Yahweh, is speaking with Jonah. As the story unfolds, he's leaving the town of Tarshish, heading to Joppa, and he has to get to Nineveh. Now, what the heck do those names mean to us when it's January 2021? Well, folks, it's like leaving Toronto, which is a good call. And then Jonah makes it to Fenelon Falls, which is not bad. That's good. It's good. But it's not as good as the hub of the Kawartha's, Bob Cajun. That's where Jonah needs to go. And lo and behold, that's where we are. Now, what happens on the way? This is where we're going to begin. Right here, you see the boat, sailors. Jonah hears God's call. He has to go to Nineveh. That's where we have our Old Testament reading from. However, he goes on a ship, okay? And we even see this same story and the ship on verse 141, right from the reading from the Quran, a ship fully laden. Now, what happens is rough seas. The sailors get scared. Jonah, he casts lot. He is condemned. He gets tossed overboard. Hear the splash. Now, Jonah is in the water. The seas are calm. The sailors are frightened. Wow, look at this. We got rid of Jonah. They're paying homage to God. Now, what happened? Jonah's in the water. He doesn't make it to shore. Unfortunately for Jonah, there was not an active coast guard at the time of this writing. So, poor old Jonah, he gets gobbled up by, is it a whale or is it a fish? You look right here, I love, this is one of my favorite rooms in the church. I've nicknamed it, and Sue goes along with me, so thank you, Sue. We call it the Jonah room. It's actually the St. David's room, but I like the Jonah room. Because of the image you see on the screen right now. There's the big whale, and it's going to gobble up Jonah. However, let's look from our Old Testament reading, the Hebrew word. Interesting things happen, folks, when you start translating languages coming from 2,000-3,000 years ago, 4,000 years ago, into modern-day contemporary English. Dag Gadol. Let's get you see that right on your screen. Dag Gadol. There we go. It's Hebrew. Now, it does not mean whale. It actually means giant fish. So you see, when I told you I had something fishy to share, I really do have something fishy to share with you. And not only giant fish, but now you see the picture on the screen right now. This was on display when we did the reading of the Quran. You see, it is a giant fish. Okay, now this is important. I've already covered this gospel miracle, but you remember something to reflect on, going on a little tangent related, the miracle of the feeding of the 5,000, the loaves of bread, and the two fish. Well, all I can say, folks, if those two fish were like the Jonah fish, no wonder Jesus could feed everyone, because that's a lot of sushi. I mean, that's one big fish. I mean, this is really something fishy. But let's go deeper into the text. So Jonah's falling down, and here comes the whale or large fish. And now Jonah is swallowed. Now on the screen, he's inside the fish. Cold, isolated, no human contact. He's in there for 3 days, 3 nights. See, foreshadowing. 3 days, 3 nights, crucifixion to resurrection, 3 days, 3 nights. What would a person do? I talked about this. Imagine, we're stuck there in the whale. What if you're hungry? I mean, can you order like barbecue back ribs? How does Uber Eats deliver that? I mean, I don't even know. I'm assuming since it's a whale or a giant fish, it's probably seafood, which is probably on the menu. So hopefully, I don't know if you can order shrimp or something like that. But, you know, when you look at poor Jonah in that picture, let's now look at January 2021. Is there anything similar going on to what the whale or the giant fish and to what we're living? That the name of the whale I'm going to put forth, it's closed the church. Yeah, the COVID whale. We're in our little bubble. Don't have as much human contact as we did. Just look how we're doing the worship services. Something like what Jonah had to experience. The COVID pause. We see something interesting amongst all our readings today. Right from Jonah, he does escape. Okay, see on the next slide, see the illustration, the whale coming up, Jonah's hightailing it, he's out of there. I don't blame him. Because why? Why was going on? He repents, placing God first. Remember the words I mentioned, growing in faith together, Sinbad the sailor, keep your focus on God, okay? Remember from our gospel reading, Jesus is going to make the disciples fishers of people, the Christ compass. We can have our own desires, what we're going to do with our life, whether we're working, whether in a position of leadership. We can have our own goals, our own agendas. If they're not God's, we may be running into trouble. Things may be good. We think we can maybe fool God. As Jonah, if he could run away, hop on a ship. Oh, I don't have to go down to Nineveh. No, I don't want to go there. Those people will never change. However, what do we see? They actually clearly do change. He made it clear for 40 days and nights. Another biblical number. Remember in the story of Noah, rain for 40 days, 40 nights. The people of Nineveh do change. There is an inward change. God see this. The city is not destroyed. Folks, here's a message of hope. All the people of Nineveh, rich, poor, women, men, they all come, they listen to the prophet Jonah. Now, let's go into the New Testament. From Matthew 12, 38, 44, and its parallel text, Luke 11, 30, Jesus says a phrase, the sign of Jonah. He calls Jonah as a sign to his people, just as Jesus himself is a sign to what's about to come, and still a sign for us today. So while we're in, I'm not in the belly of a whale, I haven't been gobbled up by a big fish, and I'm confident that this summer, when I'm kayaking out in front of Sue and Pat's place, I'm confident a big fish won't come up and get me. However, if it does, I'll keep my cell phone with me, so I will call Pat to come and rescue me. So I'm confident that can happen. So if I just disappear for a while, folks, don't worry, I'll be back. That this pause that we're in right now, what does it mean for us? And I'm not gonna be the minister, because there's plenty of places you can go. Is going to tell you what to believe. I've heard this before. What does it mean for you to follow the Christ compass? Here you go. Important question. I'm going to ask it again. What does it mean for you to follow Christ? Okay? Let's work on that. There's many different answers to that question. Many churches throughout the world today, different opinions. What we see in the story of Jonah, and how in the gospel reading in Mark, verses 14 through 20, Jesus is going to make the disciples fishers of people. The human family is very diverse, and there's a lot of interpretation, some liberal, some others more conservative, on what the gospel message means. Okay? But with all this diversity, we struggle. Where I see the light is right behind me, the cross. That's where the buck stops for me. That's where, you know, the sushi doesn't go beyond the cross. It stops right there. And following the Christ compass, that's my guiding light. So whether there are people who, when they hear the story of Jonah, and there are Christian communities in the world today, that yes, this is a real story. It somehow actually happened. Literal or metaphorical, or a combination of the two, or something else. We're all human. All created by God. We're all created in the image of God and followers of Christ Jesus. And that just like the people of Nineveh, okay, put aside their disagreements, put them aside, and come together. The city is saved. So, when we're in the COVID pause right now, the doors will reopen this year. We're going to be going forth with our worship life, all the numerous activities. That's going to be quite a learning experience for me, because I've only been here when the church is closed. But it'll be interesting to have a service and see people out there in the seats. Right now we have a lot of invisible people. They all use that cloaking device that's the folks on Star Trek use. That's how I see them. They're all cloaked, but the cloaking device will be removed later in 2021, and there will be people, and it'll be interesting to see what happens, because there's a variety of opinion even within our community of faith. And folks, I want to affirm diversity, okay? Your opinions, and feel free to express them. And come forth right there. See the cross right behind me? That's where the buck stops for me. And we love each other. The messages I've been talking about, love, unity, they were echoed yesterday, the inauguration speech. Now, I can say President Biden was talking about hope and unity, okay? Americans, some very strong opinions, but it's time to come together. So when I look, in conclusion, at the story of Jonah, I see it bringing hope. I see it bringing unity. And yes, it is. It is. You can be a cynic and say, oh, Andrew, but that was only for a certain time. Then the next prophet, yes, yes, yes. Because Jesus is coming, bringing hope and unity. But however, the love of the Father, it remains with us. And regardless of we may be Christian, Jew, Buddhist, female, male, however you wish to identify, rich, poor, white, black, brown, we all have our common humanity. And let's affirm that diversity and our different opinions and come together around the cross, that we can hold different opinions and very different opinions, but still love each other. Have our community of faith that invokes, demonstrates unity. We give hope to each other. When we're lonely, we love each other. These are the qualities that Christ brings when we are fishers of people. That the cross is much more important than our differences. Because when I look, I know before I arrived here, in just my short time here, there's some issues which, oof, fireworks! And some people, and they're free to do so, may wish to leave. However, for me, the cross is much more important than any specific issue. And the cross symbolizes for me love. What we hear from Jonah, hope, unity. What Christ is talking about in the gospel message, enabling us to be fishers of people. So we, through our own hands, hope, unity, and when these doors open, let's continue to fish. And I believe, folks, our community of faith will grow and people will see something really exciting here, and we will be the place to be. Hope, unity, and love. Christ has died. He hath risen. He shall come again. Amen. Concerns and announcements. I have seen the joy in the announcements, and that's exactly where I will begin, folks. As we continue on with the fishy theme, we're going to go deeper into the water tomorrow with, I love it, the Bible study. It's very, very exciting, and we're going to see a group that's just growing here at Trinity in Providence, because we're really cool. So, of course, that's where you want to be, feasting on the Word. And folks, don't worry, if you can't come tomorrow, we're going to do it again once every 2 weeks, so twice a month. So if you miss tomorrow, catch the next one. We've had a couple, and I've loved it, the questions. Something I want to address with, I know there's a name. There's some, I don't know, maybe some, what am I trying to say, discomfort with the words Bible and study when you put the two together. Now, for me, maybe it's because I'm a recent grad, 2017, from seminary, and a lot of the folks, when we'd go theology on tap, well, I mean, we were all studying, we all had exams, and paying tuition, but folks, I want to say that we have fun, okay? We make the Bible cool, it's fun, and You don't need a theological education. Okay? You don't need to be reading the Bible your whole life to participate. You are knowledgeable exactly as you are right now. If you're a member of this community of faith, you are knowledgeable. If you have a friend, well, maybe a loved one, a relative, who would like to come and join us, they are welcome. And you, your friend, are qualified. You have a belief in God, whatever that may look like, because there's also a lot of diversity amongst what is God and what does being a follower of Christ mean. We discuss those things respectfully. So, folks, I encourage you, let's feast on the word together. Favorite hymns? We'd love to hear from you. Send us your favorite hymns and we will put them in the worship service. Also, coffee hour again. I want to see some, let's get up to 20. So let's make an interest, let's talk about that. And the question, if you can't come up with one when you go to the breakout rooms, my analogy, the image you see on the screen right now, Jonah inside the whale. How do you feel about your bubble? What COVID has done? We're not actually inside a whale, but we don't have the same access to the outside world like we used to, which clearly Jonah did not have the same access to the outside world which he once had before he was inside the giant fish. So, question, what do you do with the COVID pause? That's just a suggestion, but look forward to hearing thoughts, opinions, and discussion from the breakout room at coffee hour. And then, of course, February birthdays. Barb Morgan on the 1st, Barbara Wicks on the 2nd, Josh Thomas on the 4th, Bill Thomas on the 8th, Joe Schnell on the 12th, and Sherry Telford on the 13th. There's many more. And of course, something else, the 14th February, Valentine's Day. Love will be coming forth from these doors to your front home. So if you do feel lonely, we're going to be sending love from Trinity and Providence to you. Folks, for people in our community of faith who are feeling lonely, whether they be at home or in the hospital, we uphold them in prayer. Susan Murray and her family, Mary Fetty, her family, family of Shirley Harrison, and the people that I have not named. God, we ask you to be with them, to embrace them in Christ's love, and let them know that they are loved. In Christ's name I pray. Amen. Lord's Prayer. Thank you. Let us come, help us to guide us. Through the Christ compass, we come forward, offer our gifts, whatever they may be, helping with the administration of the church, cleaning around the church property, helping with the worship service, and our financial givings, the three ways that we can give, whether it's writing a check to Trinity United Church, pre-authorized remittance, or an e-transfer. God, the gifts that we bring, let us lift them up and transform them into song to feed a hungry world. Amen. Gifts and offerings, bless them and help us use them to fulfill, to become fishers of people and spreading hope, unity, and love amongst all our friends and family and relations. Amen. Before I get to the commission benediction, something I want to say in the announcements. Rumors. Sometimes this happens. The image you see on the screen, I have to do some research on this, but I will be updating you. You see the Bank of Bob Cajun, the Bob. Now, B-O-B. This is not BMO. So it's not Bank of Montreal, not Bank of Nova Scotia. This is B-O-B. What is this? Well, folks, in the upcoming announcements, I will do a follow-up and let you know what is this image, you know, where did it come from? The second announcement I have, when I was filming Karen, I found something quite interesting in my video. You're seeing it on the screen right now. That's Little Bob channel. And in the corner, there's this lamp. Very interesting, this smoke rising up from the lamp. What is this? Folks, these two things, the Bank of Bob Cajun and this interesting lamp, I will be researching and I will be following up with you, updating what is this origin. Something I mentioned in Gift, Growing in Faith, the jinn, they are created from smokeless fire. So I will be exploring with my crack research team. I am very fortunate to have Sue to help, you know, keeps me organized, and we will follow up and get to the bottom of this. And now, for a commission and benediction, the word I'm going to withdraw is unity. Folks, when I talked about earlier the cross, for me, that's where the buck stops. The cross is big enough. It has enough love to embrace all our differences. It started with the crucifixion, which is awful, but it ended with the resurrection, that Christ is here today. And let us take that theme of unity and now lift it up in song.